So we will start with the chapter number 9, that is some applications of trigonometry. In the introduction to trigonometry, we have discussed that we have to find the side, the ratio of the side with the other side. We can find the angles, and that trigonometry is just related to the chapter in which we will discuss about the right angle triangle. And the trigonometry is finding the relation with the acute angles with the side, or you can say with the angles also. Means this is all about the right angle triangle. We can't apply this trigonometry in any other type of triangle. It is only applicable to a right angle. Now, in the sum applications to trigonometry, we are again using the same concept. We can use the identities. We can use the complementary angle, trigonometric table we will use. We can use all the concept of the previous chapter. But here, you will see the statement type sums of that chapter, of this chapter. In this, you will find the angles, or you will find the missing sides of the triangle. Okay, so here, let's consider the basic concept that you will listen the term elevation and depression in this chapter. So let's understand the meaning of the term angle of depression and angle of elevation. So here, I'm giving you one simple example. Suppose a person is standing here on the ground, one person is here, and he is looking at the top of this building. He is looking at the top of this building, and the person is standing here. From his eyes and from this horizontal level, this horizontal line, this is your horizontal line, and this line is called the line of sight. Line of sight means the line which is forming from the eyes of the person on the top of the building. That line is called the line of sight. And this is the object to which the person is looking for. So this angle formed here is called theta, that is called angle of elevation. That is theta. So whenever the person is standing here on the ground and he is looking, whenever the person, it's not compulsory that the person is always standing on the ground. Maybe the person is standing at the building, the top of the building, and from there he is looking at the top of the another building which is on the little bit upward side of this. So here also, in this case also, the angle of elevation is formed. And if the so that means the angle of elevation is formed when the person is looking in the upward direction to the object. And in the reverse direction, if the person is standing on the top of the building and is looking at the object on the ground, the person is standing here and the person is looking at the object which is available here at the ground. So in this case, what will happen? The angle will be formed between the line of sight. This is the line of sight means jo us person ki eyes se line form ho rahi hai, and the horizontal line. Always the angle will be formed between the horizontal line and the line of sight. This angle will be theta. As you can see, that triangle is forming here. So we want this angle in the inner side, in the interior of this triangle. So can I write here theta? They are alternate interior angles, because the lines, these two lines are parallel, and this is the transverse. So here these two angles are equal. This is alternate interior angle, but this angle which is formed on the upper side is called angle of depression. But if you start from this angle of depression, you can't solve it here. So you have to bring this angle inside the triangle to find the relation using the trigonometric ratio. To find the side, you can find the angle by using the trigonometric relation that we have discussed in the chapter number 8 in exercise 8.1. So in this way, this is called the angle of depression, and this type of angle is called angle of elevation. नीचे से ऊपर देख रहे हैं एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन, ऊपर से नीचे देख रहे हैं एंगल ऑफ डिप्रेशन. इज इट ओके? एनी डाउट, एनीथिंग यू वांट टू आस्क बेटा? इज इट क्लियर? सो व्हाट यू विल डू इज द बोथ द फिगर्स आर गिवन इन योर बुक. सो यू विल ड्रॉ दीज टू फिगर्स. I will send you the introduction. It's not appropriately given in the book. So I will send you the introduction. You will write that. That's all about the introduction of this chapter, because this chapter is in continuation with the previous chapter. So the things that we have discussed in the chapter number 8, that all things will be used here also. ठीक है? तो वही है, बस figure आपने form करनी है और question start करनी है. So should I start with the next, with the first exercise? Only one exercise is there. So I'm starting with that exercise. ठीक है? Any doubt in this? Now let's start with exercise 9.1. Introduction I will send you after the class, that you will note down in the FEAR notebook. Then you will start with the exercise 9.1. Now the question number one is, the figure is given, but I am again reading the statement for you. A circus artist is climbing a 20 meter long rope. This is your 20 meter long rope. The artist is walking on this rope, which is tightly stretched and tied from the top of the vertical pole to the ground. कहता pole है, ये pole है. इस pole के top से ये जो rope है, इसे ground के साथ attach किया गया है. Find the height of this pole. If the angle made by the rope with the ground, the angle formed by the rope with the ground is 30 degrees. This angle is given to you. Is it clear? The figure is given. You have to find this missing height of the pole. So what you will do here is, firstly, you will give the name to the triangle ABC. And obviously the pole is making 90 degrees with the ground, because it is standing vertically, so it will make 90 degrees. So here, triangle ABC is a right angled triangle. AC is 20 meter, angle C is 30 degrees, which is acute, and we need to find here is to find. What we are finding is, we are finding the height of the pole, that is AB. That's all. I have written the things. Now, we want to find this. The side which is opposite to the acute angle, the side which is opposite to the angle is your perpendicular. And this is your hypotenuse. As you know that hypotenuse is the longest side, which is always fixed. So this is your perpendicular. This is your base. So the side opposite to the angle is your perpendicular. Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Can you tell me the ratio? Which type of ratio is it? Is it sine, cos, tan, cot? ये क्या form हो रहा है? This is your perpendicular upon hypotenuse is your sine. So we are finding sine 30 is your perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Sine 30. Can you tell me the value of sine 30? Yes, Dhavnesh. Diksha. Aditi. No one is there in the class.
1 by 2.
Yes, sine 30 is your 1 by 2. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. AB we have to find, that you will write same. AC is your 20. Now cross multiply, AB is 20 by 2, that is 10 meter. That is 10 meter. So the height of the pole is 10 meter. Height of the pole is 10 meter. So you will write the answer at the end. Height of the pole is 10 meter. Is it clear? Any doubt? I'm starting with the next question. If you have any doubt in this question, you can ask. The most important thing is that in this chapter is you have to understand the question and you have to form the correct figure. If your figure is correct, you will be able to reach at the correct answer. Otherwise, not. So in the beginning, questions are easy, but if you will see for the extra questions, questions are little bit complicated, but with enough of practice, you will be able to get perfection. Question number two is, a tree breaks due to storm. This is your tree. Suppose the tree has broke from this point and this broken part is touching the ground here. This is your A, B, C, D. Now the question is, the tree breaks ground due to storm and the broken part bends so that the top touches the ground and makes 30 degree angle with the base. The distance between the foot of the tree, this is the foot of the tree. The distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground. This top touches the ground here and the distance is your 8 meter. Find the height of the tree. You have to find this height. You have to find this height, complete height you have to find. Actually, this is the total height of the tree, but the tree broke from here. So this top AB is equal to BD because this part is bending in this direction and touching at D point. What you will do here is you will write all the details. AC is the tree. CD is your 8 meter, which is given. Angle D is your 30 degree, which is given. To find, what we want to find is, we want to find the complete height of the tree, that is AC. Now start with the solution. In triangle BCD, again, the tree is standing vertically, so it makes 90 degree here with the base. So this triangle BCD is your right angle triangle. BCD is the right angled triangle. So in this, what you will do is, you will find this. Actually, what we want here is, we want BC and BD both. Why? Kyunki AB aur BD kya hai? Equal. AC kya hai? That is the complete length of the triangle. Tree. And AC can be written as AB plus BC. Or AB kiske equal hai? BD ke equal hai. AB kiske equal hai? BD ke equal hai. This is clear? Is it clear? ये और ये आपस में इक्वल है। अब आपको ये चाहिए और ये भी चाहिए, एंगल के सामने वाली साइड परपेंडिकुलर, परपेंडिकुलर बेस गिवन है, परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन बेस क्या होता है? अदिति, अदिति रेज योर हैंड, हरिया, छियांग, गरिमा, गुरकिरत, यस अदिति,
मैम टैन,
मैम टैन थीटा,
यस इट इज टैन थीटा, कैन यू टेल मी द वैल्यू ऑफ टैन 30, व्हाट इज टैन 30 अदिति?
1/√3, 1/√3,
1/√3, व्हाट इज टैन 60?
रूट थ्री,
टैन 45,
1,
साइन 30,
1/2,
और कॉस में 1/2 कब आता है? कॉस की लाइन में
टैन 60, ओ सॉरी कॉस 60,
कॉस 60, यस एग्जैक्टली, गुड। नाउ हियर इन दिस वी विल फाइंड द बीसी फर्स्ट, देन वी विल फाइंड बीडी, एंड इफ वी एड बोथ दीस थिंग यू विल गेट द लेंथ ऑफ द कंप्लीट ट्री, एंटायर ट्री एसी। सो tan 30 is equal to perpendicular upon base, perpendicular is your BC and base is your CD. Now solve this, tan 30 is your 1/√3, BC we want to find and CD is your 8. Now cross multiply, BC is your 8/√3, is it okay? Or is there any need to solve it further? Whenever the root is there in the denominator, you will rationalize it. It will be 8√3/3. Ye BC aa gaya aapke paas. Now we want to find this BD. Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Kisi se bhi find kar sakte ho. Base upon hypotenuse, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. कुछ भी, कोई भी, जो भी आपको समझ आता है आप कर सकते हो। नाउ वी आर यूजिंग साइन 30 एज परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन हाइपोटेन्यूज, परपेंडिकुलर इज योर बीसी एंड हाइपोटेन्यूज इज योर बीडी दैट वी वांट टू फाइंड हियर। साइन 30 इज 1/2 एज अदिति हैज टोल्ड मी, साइन 30 इज 1/2, बीसी इज योर, बीसी वी हैव गॉट एज 8√3/3, BD you will write here same. Now cross multiply this, 3 times BD is your 16√3, BD is your 16√3/3, BD is your 16√3/3. आपके पास BC भी आ गया, BD भी आ गया। अब हमने क्या करना है? लेंथ ऑफ ट्राइंगल फाइंड करनी है, हाइट ऑफ ट्राइंगल, हाइट, सॉरी हाइट ऑफ ट्री, दैट इज ए बी प्लस बी सी, और ए बी किसके इक्वल है? ए बी प्लस बी सी, ए बी किसके इक्वल है? बी डी के। आपने नहीं लिखना, आप सीधा भी कर सकते हैं, बट मेरा आपको काम है पूरा बताना, आपकी मर्जी है। 24√3/3, दैट इज 8√3 मीटर। प्लीज चेक आउट द यूनिट, इज इट मीटर, सेंटीमीटर, व्हाट सो एवर इज दिस, यू विल राइट दैट। दिस इज द आंसर दैट यू विल राइट एट द एंड, write these two portion, then you will write the height of the tree at the end. Any doubt in this? Any doubt, beta? So after this, I'm giving you one small extra question. You please all solve it so that I can check your clarity of concept. Now I want you to solve the questions at your own so that you have practice and you will be perfect. Yes, I'm writing one, drawing one figure here. No, it's not visible. यहाँ बना x, y, this is 45, this is 6 meter. x, y find कर लो. x, y find कर लो. करो find. And after this, you will start with the third question of the 9.1. Hurry up. Solve this. Find x and y. आप ऐसे भी कर सकते हो, एक साइड फाइंड कर लो, पाइथागोरस थ्योरम से फाइंड द अनदर साइड. पहले वाई फाइंड कर लो, एक्स आ जाएगा, एक्स फाइंड कर लो, वाई आ जाएगा. Yes, Arman.
I'm done.
X की वैल्यू
6 meter.
And y
6 under 2 meter.
Yes, good. Which type of triangle is this? Gur Kirak, Gur Sevak. Gur Sevak, can you on your video? Gur Sevak, Saharsh, Divita, Mishti, Khushi. Khushi, if the two sides of this triangle are 6, 6 and the hypotenuse is 6 root 2, can you tell me the type of triangle? Which type of triangle is this? If two sides are equal, then it is isosceles
triangle.
Right angle triangle. Isosceles right angle triangle.
Right angle.
Now start the third question of your book. In the third question, a contractor plans to install two slides in a garden. One is for the age of 5 year children and one slide is for the age of, for the children whose age is, whose for the elder children, age is not given. इसमें जो स्लाइड लगाना है इसकी हाइट है 1.5 मीटर एंड विच इज इंक्लाइंड टू द ग्राउंड एट 30 डिग्री एंड द अनदर स्लाइड हुज हाइट इज 3 मीटर एंड इंक्लाइंड टू द ग्राउंड एट 60 डिग्री फाइंड द व्हाट शुड बी द लेंथ ऑफ द स्लाइड इन ईच केस व्हाट विल बी द लेंथ ऑफ द स्लाइड इन ईच केस दैट यू हैव टू दिस इज फॉर द चिल्ड्रन हुज एज इज बिलो 5 year and this is for the elder children. So two slides are there. One is for the junior kids and one is for the little bit above age. So you have to find the length of the slide. If you want to make this in the one, you can make, but it's better to draw it separately. अगर आप एक में बनाना चाहते हो ना, तो ये वाला आप स्टार्ट ऐसे बनाओगे, ये 1.3 सॉरी 1.5, ये 3, ये एंगल 30, ये पूरे वाला 60। अगर आप एक फिगर बनाना चाहते हो तो आप ये वाली फिगर बनाओगे, ठीक है? करो स्टार्ट, गिव द नेम टू द ट्रायंगल। A, B, C, D, E, F. इस ट्रायंगल में पहले AC फाइंड करो, इसमें DF फाइंड करो। आप डिटेल लिखना चाहो तो लिख सकते हो। AC इज द स्लाइड, AB इज द हाइट ऑफ द स्लाइड, एंगल C इज 30 डिग्री। In triangle DEF, DF is the slide, DE is 3 meter, angle F is 60 degree. Angle के सामने वाली side perpendicular, perpendicular upon hypotenuse is your sine. Sine 30 is your perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. AB is your 1.5, AC is your this, AC you will get as 3. After cross multiplication, the length of the slide is 3 meter. And in the next, angle ke samne wali side perpendicular, sine 60 is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is DE upon DF. And sine 60 is your, क्या होता है ये, क्या होता है बेटा, कौन बताएगा ये वैल्यू sine 60? यस कृतिका
मैम, रूट 3/2।
यस इट्स रूट 3/2। DE is your 3, DF, cross multiply this, DF is 6 by 3, 2s are 6 by root 3. Is it okay? Rationalize it, because whenever the root is there in the denominator, you have to rationalize it. 6 root 3 by 3, that is 2 root 3. So, aapke paas ek slide ki length aagi 3 meter, dusre ki length aagi 2√3 meter. So the length of the two slides is 3 meter and 2√3 meter. Start the fourth question. Start the fourth question. Draw the figure. Yes, Kritika, having any doubt?
No, ma'am, wo galti se tha.
So write the answer at the end. Length of the two slides are 3 meter and 2√3 meter. 3 meter and 2√3 meter. In the fourth question, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a point on the ground is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. I'm reading again. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from the point on the ground, which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower, is 30 meter. Find the height of the tower. ये डिस्टेंस आपको दिया हुआ 30 मीटर, हाइट यू हैव टू फाइंड. ए बी इज हाइट ऑफ टावर, एंगल सी इज 30 डिग्री विच इज एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन, बी सी इज योर 30 मीटर. नाउ